Does a little provocation cause you to erupt in violent displays of anger? Are there people or situations in your past over which you are still holding grudges? Does there always seem to be conflict and strife present in your life? In the series Biblical Solutions to the Spirit of Anger, Pastor Chika Onuza provides biblically based remedies to recognize, counter, and overcome the insidious spirit of anger. You will learn what drives the anger in our lives and understand the root causes of anger. Biblical Solutions to the Spirit of Anger not only uncovers the reasons and methods by which Satan uses anger, but it also reveals God's purpose behind the people or circumstances that are causing the frustration, aggravations, and resentments. Don't allow the enemy to thwart your destiny any longer. Study the Biblical Solutions to the Spirit of Anger series to release the flow of God's blessing in your life.
Praise the Lord and welcome to another day on the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. The Lord is dealing with our hearts. The Lord is instructing us how to live anger-free. Do you want to live anger-free? That's our theme this week. I hope you listened to me yesterday. The Lord taught us that the root of anger is pride, the first root. Have you ever seen people you say, no, he is very opinionated. He's just somebody who has just a little more pride than you do. And they can turn around and say the same thing about you. But beloved, pride is the first root of anger. Watch yesterday's broadcast. We want to consider the next root this morning. Lust. Lust. A strong desire for anything. Do you know what breeds the most or the fiercest arguments and conversations in life? It's called the lust of vindication. You want to prove that you are right, particularly when someone opposes what you said. You get so angry and so offended. I want you to consider the text we read yesterday so we can see deeper mysteries concerning the anger we struggle with. The Bible says that when the wisdom is natural or earthly, it says it has two other characteristics. It calls it sensuality. It says it is sensual and devilish. Look at it, James chapter 3, verse 14 once again. But if you have bitter envy and strife in your hearts, glory not and lie not against the truth. This wisdom descended not from above. It's a wisdom, all right, but it's not coming from heaven, but is earthly, sensual, and devilish. One of the most humbling things, beloved, that will help you deal with the spirit of anger in your life is the realization that there is a spirit feeding you all that information that gives you those quick retorts, those cutting remarks, those piercing words. They did not originate from you. Beloved, the Bible says this wisdom did not descend from heaven, you see, but it is coming from the earth, and it is sensual, and he says it's devilish. There is a spirit behind it, but between the word spoken and the spirit behind it is the spirit of lust. Whenever lust, whether it is sexual lust or cravings for sweets or anything of the sort, or escapes in movies or vindication, as I already mentioned, you will notice a very strong tendency to pride and anger. This is how you know lust has entered your life. Very small provocations lead to huge explosions. Little things just make you so angry, and you cannot control it. Lust. That at such times, you should really take some time to start reading the word, fasting, and praying, so that your lust level will go down. That may be a time to have some fellowship with your wife or husband to help you in those dimensions. And if you're not married, then you really have to fast and pray. But you know, lust is there even when you are married. So it's a spirit. It's never satisfied. It's coming out of a dissatisfaction. You are dissatisfied with everything, with food, with home, with work, with church, with everybody. Lust. It fuels anger. We have these three dominant forces. Pride driving my lust, both of them driving my anger. Yes, beloved. He says, this wisdom is not from above. It is earthly, it is sensual, and is devilish. He says, for where envy and strife is, there is confusion. Do you notice that whenever you get angry, you just lose control? Your thoughts start running together. You get all confused. You forget what it was you were trying to say or what we are looking for, because it just takes you away. You veer off totally. May the Lord help you get a hold of your anger. May the Lord help you control your lust. And He will help your anger come down. Crucifying the flesh is the only solution. The Lord will help all of us. In Jesus' name. Amen. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow. God bless you. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you.
Yes, He is, yes, He is, yes, He is, yes, He is.